The iconic symbol of the critical chain way is the fever chart. Let me explain what it is. Okay, we've got a horizontal axis, right, which shows the progress of the project from its beginning to its end here, right? That measures progress on the critical chain, which is, let's say, a close cousin to the critical path. It just doesn't take into account non-critical activities, okay? And the durations of those different tasks are, in fact, optimistic or focused durations, okay? So we're not expecting to be able to honour those times. We're going to take longer than that. And so there is the other axis, the buffer, which is there to absorb the fact that we're going to go slower than the optimistic durations, okay? It is big, that's to say that it's approximately one third of the overall duration. So for instance, in a product development, you might have 2 years of focused or optimistic duration and a whole year of a buffer, right? So let's take an example and see what a project during execution will look like on a fever chart, okay? So we start off, obviously we start off with, at the beginning, 0% progress and 0% consumption of the buffer, okay? And at the end of the first week, we look at where we are and we see that, well, we've progressed, but we've consumed a little bit of the buffer, not much, but just a little bit. That's perfectly normal, that's what it's there for, right? We went slightly slower than optimistic. Second week, even more consumption of buffer. Third week, further up. We're now getting into the orange and red zone. And on the fourth week, well, we didn't progress hardly at all, okay? And we're way up into the red zone, okay? If we carry on like that, in fact, we're going to end up late, because where is the date we promised? The date we promised is up here. It's in the top right-hand corner, right? That's what we promised to the top management or to the client. And when on that week four we're over here, right, if we carry on like that, we're going to end up late. So we know we have to react. We have a meeting. We see what we can do to speed up the program. Is it adding people? Is it problem solving this or that? And we find a solution. And so on the fifth week, we've gone back down because we went faster than the expected average, faster than the focus duration. And finally, on the sixth week, we finish the project. We finish it down in the limits of the orange and green zone. That's to say we're finishing it early. This is what you're aiming for when you're planning things and executing the critical chain way, right? It's just like when you take an aeroplane, right? How do you ensure you don't miss aeroplanes? You plan to finish the project of getting to the plane a little bit early, and you will waste time at the boarding gate waiting for the call to embark. Okay, it's the same in project management. If you want to finish all your projects on time, you aim to finish them a little early. Okay, and the colours that are on this chart, right, the green, the orange and the red, are purely empiric. What we're saying is if you're in the green, you're within normal uncertainty, normal noise, and at the other extremity, in the red, you've got many more problems than you expected, right? And the orange zone between the two, some people decide not to, in fact, have it in their fever charts, but it's to indicate, watch out, you're about to reach the red zone. Okay, so I hope that's made it clear. This is the iconic fever chart of the critical chain way. Thank you very much. Bye-bye.